Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is Hany Ismail from Planning Engineer website. In this video, we are going to discuss a very important document, shop drawing log. Also, we will discuss the procurement log. As we agreed, this course is giving you the project management fundamentals. So let's start with the shop drawing log. Planning is not for construction activities only. Planning is for every step in your project. Shop drawing stage is critical and could lead to unforeseen delays. Managing shop drawing phase starts from planning. What drawings do you need first, and understand the critical drawings and continuously monitoring the submittal approval process along the project. So typically we have this scenario that you have shop drawing submittal, then you have shop drawing approval, then you have the relevant activity. Sometimes you schedule it for one approval submission, which is not actually the current situation in the project, because you might submit your drawing, then you have comments, then you have again to resubmit your drawings. So here we will assume, or we will set up a duration for each stage, and we should be sure that we will finish or get the approval of the shop drawing before the start date of the construction activity. For example, here we have 7 days for shop drawing submittal, 14 days for approval. Then we should start 21 days before the construction or relevant construction activity. As I mentioned, the approval from first submission is not the very best scenario. The approval from second submission is most likely. Like you have here to submit your shop drawings, then your shop drawing get rejected or you have some comments, then you submit it again, then they will take the approval period again for review, then you get it approved. From this diagram, we'll see that 40 days before the construction activity start, we should start the process of shop drawing submittal. Even I'm not taking it as a 40 days, I should have here between the approval and the construction activity a safe time period. In my opinion, this should be not less than 1 month. Because if you are delayed a little bit here or something happen here, you still have some floats. We talk about float before. I'm talking here about the free float. The free float is the amount of time an activity can be delayed without affecting the successor activity. So here we are going to be in the safe side because we don't want to delay anything. That's the strategy of building or linking the shop drawing. So planners should coordinate with the design or construction team to identify which drawing might not be approved from the first submission. Shop drawing submission date shall be relevant to the activity planned start date, not too early, not too close. However, to be too early, it is not a big deal, but to be too close, you are putting your project in risks. Because shop drawing phase is complicated and critical, everything should be well monitored and controlled. That's why we're using shop drawing log. Shop drawing log is normally an Excel sheet that contains all the details of every drawing cycle and its current status. Let me show you an example of it. This is a shop drawing log. We have here, let's say, trade or the section, and you have here some organization. We can call it WBS if you want. So we have here the civil structural. We have here the drawings, the revision, we have the submittal date, return date, code, and the status. This is the simplest format of a shop drawing log you might have. Also, it will be a very good if you can add some more column here to explain the planned start or to show the planned start. So whoever is following this log will know that this drawing should be submitted on this date and should be approved in this date. If you notice here, we have code. The code we have BAC. This is not mandatory, but this is the standard. That the code A, when a drawing got code A, it means approved with no comments. This is the best practice. Code B, it means approved with comments. Code C, it means revise and resubmit. Code D, it means rejected. So what's the differences between code A and code B? Both are approved. Both you can proceed with the work on site. But here you have some comments, not major comments, minor comments you need to consider while executing your works. So since B is approved with comment and C revise and resubmit, both they have comments. But in that case, comments here preventing you from executing the work. For example, you are submitting a shop drawing for a slab. You mention the slab thickness is 20 centimeters while the designer is believing that it should be 30 centimeters. So this type of comments cannot be approved with comments. Cannot be code B. It should be code C. It means you cannot proceed with the work unless you make the comments, rectify the comments, and send back to the consultant review. Okay, since code C and code D both are not approved, what is the difference between code C and code D? Code C, it means revise and resubmit. Code D, it means rejected but don't resubmit again. Why I'll not resubmit again? For example, you submitted a shop drawing for the ceiling. Instead of concrete, you made it from steel. So the consultant doesn't like this idea, so he made rejected. No, we don't need steel, we need concrete. So don't resubmit this drawing again. You need to change the concept, or you need to change the supplier, or you need to change whatever. Now I hope you understand the concept of the coding system of the shop drawings. Same apply to the materials as well. So the shop drawing log will tell you how many drawings were submitted on time, how many were delayed, how many drawings were approved, how many were rejected, percentage of approval, percentage of code C and D. Does the consultant or client take more time than planned to give you the review? These type of reports you could generate from the shop drawing log. For example, here we have shop drawing submittal. This is a plan on 100%. The actual is 96.72. So the planned approval is 100. The actual is 94. Here you can also make a shop drawing status, not submitted how many, under review how many, code C, code B, code A. Also, you can have some indications here that how many drawings more than 7 days under review, how many drawings less than 7 days, how many drawings under review. So from the shop drawing log, we can create a very useful report. Now we document all drawing detail to avoid any delays that might happen. What if we manage the drawing but neglected the material? Like the shop drawing, we should have a detailed document for procurement tracking log. Let's talk about it. Procurement log. For material, the cycle have one more step, which is PO, and also we can segregate the material as long lead items and overseas, which will be shipped from outside the countries, and normal materials. Let's see the procurement life cycle. Like the shop drawing, we have the submittal and we have the approval, but in that case we need to do more steps. We need to issue the purchase order and then wait for the material delivery. For this example, if we have the procurement cycle, we need to start 56 days before the construction date. Because the material is very critical, we cannot rely on only one submittal, one approval. We should have something more specific. And we should also be in the safe time. You need to put here more time for resubmittal and more time for approval, and put some time for the purchase order, and be sure what is the manufacturer and delivery date. You might have a very simple material that can be manufactured and shipped within 1 month, and other materials could take 6-7 months, which we called long lead materials. So contractor shall have a risk plan with a proactive actions to avoid any problems in shipment and delivery. And this is the procurement tracking log, how it looks like. So you might ask yourself, why I need to have such documents and keep recording and following? Because we agreed that project management concept, you should be proactive. You should not be a reactive. So in your opinion, how you can be a proactive in such procurement log? For example, you might have one material submitted and approved, but the submittal and approval period took too long time. Now you contacted your supplier and asked him, please ship the material as soon as possible, manufacture it. You find it will reach to the site 1 month after the required date. Now you know this information ahead of time. Now you may decide to air freight the material instead of shipping by sea. You will save 1 month. You will avoid delay penalties. So this is the concept of being proactive. Material tracking log is very simple. You have the material, revision, submittal date, return date, and code. Also, you have here the status, whether it is approved, not approved, not submitted, and you can also add the supplier name, PO date, and long lead item. The long lead, you can define whether this material is long lead item or long lead material or not. It is very important to know that this material will affect other materials or not. Also, from this procurement log, you can have a very nice charts and data telling you the planned percentage of material submittal, the planned percentage and actual for approval, what is the material status, how many material not submitted, how many under review, code C, code B, code A. For example, here, if I'm auditing this procurement log, I will question the procurement section in my company. Why you have too many materials with code B and only one material is code A? What you are missing? Why you are not getting the material approved as a code A? You might have some replies like the consultant is not giving us code A because he has comments. You need to be sure that the comments in the material submittal are all fulfilled when you are procuring the material. So I don't want to make this video too long, but I only would like to give you the concept of the shop drawings and materials logs and why they are important to any construction project. I hope you find this video useful to you. See you in the next one.